Welcome to the Amphenol Broadband Solutions Cable 101 training on Remote PHY. In this video, we'll discuss why Remote PHY is needed, explain what is Remote PHY, and show the Remote PHY architectures. Today it seems like everything we do is somehow connected to the digital world, from video streaming services, voice services, video gaming, virtual reality, social media, augmented reality, and the Internet of Things. And the demand keeps on increasing, and everyone expects a good, reliable connection to the Internet. With this demand, there's an ever-increasing competition to provide data services for a share of the customer base. Cable TV has done a great job of providing high-speed data services by continually upgrading their systems, such as with the HFC network. Here I'm showing a Node Plus 4 amplifier architecture, which is fed from a traditional head end with analog fiber to the node. This type of architecture typically services around 500 homes passed. Even with this architecture, there are some challenges. The data fed from the head end for this fiber node is shared between all the homes in the node group. The data utilization must be closely monitored to ensure that the data is not oversold, especially if very high data speed rates are supported. With DOCSIS 3.1, many systems are offering 1 gig services, and the customers are always conducting speed tests to verify that they're receiving the data that they're paying for. Another drawback of this architecture is the noise generated by the analog fiber links and the amplifier cascades. To achieve higher data rates set by the DOCSIS 3.1 standard, higher order modulations can be used, such as 512 QAM up to 4096 QAM. For these higher order modulations to work, the signal to noise of the system must be reduced. Also, the combined noise in the upstream from each of the 500 homes in the node generates a large portion of the upstream noise in the system. One way to help overcome these challenges is to do node splits. This reduces the number of homes served per node, and now there are less users sharing the data. In this example, we have a Node Plus 0 architecture, which means that after the node, it's an all-passive network. Since we eliminated the amplifier cascade, the noise of the system is reduced, which helps improve the DOCSIS 3.1 signals. But we still have the noise generated by the analog fiber link. One advantage of less homes per node is that the combined upstream noise is reduced. Also, with the node splits, that means there's more service groups, which equates to more RF connects and more CMTSs. Additional CMTSs cost money, takes up more rack space, and requires additional powering and cooling. To solve these challenges, that brings us to the distributed access architecture called DAA. In a distributed access architecture, the MAC and PHY layers of the CMTS and CCAP can be split between the head end and node devices, cabinets, MDUs, businesses, or hotel. With Remote PHY, the PHY layer is removed from the CMTS CCAP and places it in the field in the node device, cabinet, MDU, business, or hotel. With Remote MAC and PHY, the MAC and PHY layers remove from CMTS CCAP and places it in the field in the node device, cabinet, MDU, business, or hotel. The Open Systems Interconnection OSI model describes how data is sent and received over a network. This model breaks down data transmission over a series of 7 layers. With Remote PHY, we'll be dealing with the first layer, which is the physical layer, or PHY. The physical layer includes simple wiring, fiber, network cards, and anything else that is used to connect 2 network devices and allows them to communicate. Looking back at the Node Plus 0 architecture, and other traditional cable architectures, all the signals are sent, received, and processed at the head end. This is called the centralized architecture. With remote PHY, the RF line cards and modulator-demodulator function is removed from the CMTS CCAP equipment, and they're replaced with digital line cards that have Ethernet ports installed. So if we look at the head end for remote PHY, we removed the RF and mod-demod functions of the CMTS CCAP and replaced it with the digital line card, which puts out a 10 gig digital Ethernet signal. This removes all of the RF cabling, splitting, and combining from the head end. The 10 gig E is sent to an Ethernet switch. Since all signals are now digital, they are fed to and from digital fiber transmitters and digital fiber receivers, which are small plug-in modules which plug into the Ethernet switch. Advantages of digital fiber equipment is it's less noisy, less expensive, has extended range, and is more reliable than analog fiber equipment. At the node location, the fiber transmitters and receivers are digital. The PHY device receives a digital signal and generates the appropriate RF digital signals, which are then sent to the RF amplifier section to be distributed to the coaxial cable system. Remote PHY devices have fiber loop-through ports that allow one remote PHY node's fiber to feed an additional remote PHY node. This helps to save on fiber counts. Many existing fiber nodes can be fitted with the remote PHY component, typically in the lid of the node. The remote PHY device uses digital fiber transmitters and receivers and creates the RF digital carriers. The addition of the remote PHY device does increase the power draw of the node. It's been estimated that the power increase will be around 25 to 30%. This additional power cost will still be less than the savings in power costs at the head end. The remote PHY device also generates additional heat, which may be a challenge to dissipate. One solution is to have the remote PHY device in a separate housing. The digital RF output is then connected to a standard RF amplifier. This also allows the reuse of existing amplifiers. Here's an example of how that would look. There are many benefits to remote PHY. Lower signal to noise ratios allow higher order digital modulations, which equates to higher speeds. Reduced number of RF ports in the head end. Reduce the number of CMTSs. Reduced and simpler combining and splitting networks in the head end. It uses high-density Ethernet switching, which takes up less space. Uses digital optics, which reduce costs, they are more reliable, and allow further distances. There's no laser clipping in the return with digital, and reduce cooling, power, and rack space in the head end. Remote PHY can also be used to consolidate small hubs by installing a remote PHY shelf at the hub location, which feeds the hub's existing analog optics. Remote PHY can also be used to reduce the number of CMTSs when doing node splits. Instead of adding additional CMTSs, remote PHY shelves can be used in the main head end. The existing CMTS RF line cards are replaced with the digital line cards, which feeds the 10 GE digital signal to them via the Ethernet switch. So instead of buying more CMTSs, you're buying the less expensive remote PHY shelves. Another one of the distributed access architectures is remote MAC and PHY. With this, the MAC and physical layers are moved to the field. In the field, the remote MAC and PHY nodes are installed just like the remote PHY nodes were. In the head end, the CMTS is now just a router. When doing node splits, powering needs to be considered. Before the node splits, the power for the fiber nodes and the amplifiers ran through the same coaxial cable as the RF. During the node installation and the distribution plant retapping, the power path has been interrupted at several locations as shown here. Additional coaxial cable may be needed to connect the power path back through the retap distribution or to run dedicated cables just for power. Also, since the remote PHY devices use more power, Additional power supplies may be needed. Let's review what we've covered in this training session on Remote PHY. We showed why Remote PHY is needed, explained what is Remote PHY, and showed the different Remote PHY architectures. Thank you for viewing this training on Remote PHY. For additional training topics, see our website at www.amphenolbroadband.com.